The Umbrella Academy Season 2 is strong, potent stuff. And the same can be said of the setup, the expansive setup for a potential Season 3. That's right, there are rumors. I've seen a couple of you say, oh, there's one more season, Grace, but it's going to be the final season. And that might be the case. But there's no official word yet from Netflix. I checked, but come on, the announcement should come in the coming days. Because based on the incredibly strong reviews for season two, season one was good, but it's pretty much unanimous that season two blows it out of the water. That's how good season two is. But also with everything set up for season three, how can you not have at least one more season? And you have to let the people know, which is what Netflix does these days, like with Ozark, Sabrina, one more season, but it's the end, so wrap it up. Because you can't leave it like this. So yes, The Umbrella Academy Season 2 sends the Hargreaves family back to 1963. Back to the future style. It's great. As in a time period where people they knew in the present are alive, still alive, like Sir Reginald Hargreaves, Grace, Pogo. And in fact, when you think about it, they were all dead by the end of season one. So they're not only meet their younger selves, but they're still alive. And we'll talk about it. Some of them are still alive now when they come back. But here's the kicker, and I think this is very important. Many of the people that they meet in 1963 for the first time, even the adults, could still be alive when the Hargreaves return to the new present that they've created. So let's go over all the storylines that have been left deliciously dangling. Now, of course, the big reveal at the very end is that the new darker timeline, it seems darker, doesn't it? I mean, whenever Ben looks like this, I think it's darker, right? That's quite the mustache. But, you know, the Hargreaves have accidentally created a darker timeline, which also is very Back to the Future. As I just said, Ben is still alive, and that's a great way. As I said in my spoiler review, I think we've gone as far as we can with Ghost Ben. So this is a great way to keep the character around and at the same time, well, literally revitalize him. So he's alive, leading Sir Reginald Hargreaves' Sparrow Academy. The Umbrella Academy is no more. I say no more because they did mention it to him when they met him in 1963, so it was a conscious choice maybe to create the Sparrow Academy, but I'm getting ahead of myself. But we'll talk about Sir Reginald Hargreaves momentarily. But also, there seems to be a whole new roster, besides Ben, of course, picked from the 43 superpowered children born in 1989. And the show is very clever, by the way, to keep its options open. They show them in silhouette, which means they can still decide who they want to have the characters be, who's cast as them, and what their powers are. There could be, of course, even two versions of any of the 43 superpowered children we've already met, from 1 through 5 and 7, because again, Ben is already part of the group, and there's no duplicate with him, because of course his self from the original timeline died, and so beautifully sacrificed himself in season 2. And then, of course, there could be a duplicate Lila. But as for our Lila, I loved her, even though I did feel her character jump the shark in episode 10, which I discussed fully in my spoiler review. This is all about season 3. So, of course, Lila, our Lila, again, is still at large, as she disappeared out of the timeline with her very own suitcase. So she'll definitely be back. Perhaps she'll become a Loki-type anti-hero, because after some of the stuff she pulled in season 2 at the end, I certainly would never trust her, but I like her a lot. Diego certainly still likes her, and so I think at the very least they'll want to explore if there's any hope for that romance. I still think they make a nice couple, even though, again, I don't think you can trust her. Also, the Commission has a whole new leadership. Will they become a more benevolent organization, or does power corrupt? So many great options here. They're, by the way, way off the reservation of the comic. So they're in totally new territory here. There's no roadmap for us to potentially follow. Lila could go back to working for them. Maybe they patch things up, because, of course, for the Commission, they have nothing but time. And then also Diego, who Lila recruited to work temporarily for the Commission, and who when he was there, he helped the new leadership take over. He could find that he has an open invitation to return as well. I thought the Commission looked good on Diego. I like that, as I discussed in depth in my spoiler review. Then, of course, we finally got to see Sir Reginald Hargreaves take off his human mask, and we saw the back of his alien head. Was he always supposed to kill the Illuminati group that he was in charge of? He never wanted Kennedy assassinated, so maybe he always lost his temper and took them out. But maybe he wasn't supposed to. What has the change in the timeline done to him? As I said, we already know that instead of creating the Umbrella Academy, he created the Sparrow Academy. And that might have been a conscious choice because he knows a lot about the future. You know, and by the way, the Sparrow Academy looks like a bunch of punks, which is partially why we know this is a darker timeline. But as Doc Brown said, it's never good to know too much about your own future. And Hargreaves, he knows a lot because his children told him a lot. I'm also curious if Pogo is now still alive, and perhaps even Grace. Now, I, of course, for those of you who don't watch The Umbrella Academy, I am, of course, Grace, but there's also a Grace on the show who was their mother, their adopted mother, and who Hargreaves then turned into a robot. It's a great show. And then her robot broke down, much making Diego very sad. And in season two, when he goes back and meets the original human Grace, he tries to help her, and she gets actually set on a different path. So, very interesting. I think there's a chance that they're both alive. Next up, what kind of life did Sissy go to live in California? Will she and Vanya reunite as out-of-time lovers, Benjamin Button style? She did tell Vanya to come find her. Aw, man, I really wish that, part of me really wishes that Raymond and Sissy had gone along for the ride. I'm like, I love you guys, I want you to stay. And so I hope they come back as older versions of themselves. But of course, the really big question mark is her special needs son, Harlan, who now has powers thanks to Vanya. At first, he had Vanya's powers, but it seems at the very end in that tease, when he's in the car levitating that toy, that he has a different set of powers. He has like some lingering powers. I also think that he's been somewhat healed of his disability as well. I don't think he's maybe been totally healed, but I think he's able maybe to operate a little bit better. So what does he do in California? When we get to the current timeline, he will be a full adult. And so I think with being a superpowered individual, he's probably had a huge influence on the world. Not to mention, the Hargreaves have now created someone who has superpowers who predates the 43 children who were born in 1989. And of course, when they were born, they didn't even exhibit powers back then. They had to get older. So, I mean, they didn't have, it was not, it's kind of like the X-Men. I think they had powers when they were like kids, but they didn't have powers, I don't believe, at birth. But here's a superpowered individual on Earth before, you know, running around 1963. That's a huge head start on the 1989 kids. Really, really interesting. I really want to see what happens to Harlan. I suspect he might be a villain. All right, that would be really cool. Then there's Raymond Chestnut. Oh, I loved this guy, who nobly stayed behind to help the civil rights movement so the future that Allison tells him about could indeed happen. That was a wonderful personal sacrifice. But he was so great. I loved him so much. He said, "One year with you is enough than I've never having met you." I was like, "Raymond, you really always know what to say. You're a real Prince Charming." But sometimes good intentions, you know what they say about the road paved with good intentions, right? So does he know too much about the future to help it along? Maybe he cheats, or does he end up maybe also hurting it? Raymond could also still be alive in the present, which means a reunion with Allison as well. Or maybe his children are still alive, or people he's influenced. I think Raymond clearly is a leader, and it is, I think, definitely on a track to get involved with politics. You know, with John Lewis just passing away, I think, you know, having Raymond Chestnut be a John Lewis type character in this show, I think could be really touching and very appropriate. Then, speaking of followers, there's Klaus, who made quite the impression in 1963. He actually changes two big things. First off, of course, there's his cult, which lives on without him. He told them to. And in fact, as they went on down the road, literally, they picked up that one remaining Swede. Now, in 1963, the group was already pretty powerful. There were his followers all across the globe. And a number of his followers were pretty influential people. Remember, they were able to get him out of jail. He said, you know, the governor was involved in his cult. So what are they up to now? What kind of influence do they wield in the present? And also, what do they now believe? Did people like the Swede, perhaps, change the cult? Did the cult change the Swede, or did the Swede change the cult? Very interesting. And then, of course, with Klaus, I'm also talking about the very touching developments with Dave. It was beautiful how hard he tried to save Dave's life, but Dave just wouldn't let him. Or would he? Because remember, Dave's still enlisted, but he enlisted on a different day. So, while he still goes to Vietnam, the timeline has been changed. And maybe, just maybe, he does not die there. So there's a very strong chance, I believe almost 100%, because it's beautiful. It's like, how can you not do this? That Klaus will find himself able to reunite with a dashing older Dave in the present, which again would just be so moving. Oh, I can't wait. Klaus, he was so working hard to accomplish that and save Dave for all the right reasons. I would just be so happy if he accomplished that. By the way, romance on this show is particularly well done. All the couples, I just love them all. Then as for Five, he's decided he doesn't want to kill anymore. But will the world let him? Also, Aidan Gallagher is getting older. So it will be interesting to see how the show decides to address that and explore it. Also, will season three be about fixing this new timeline yet again? Is it not maybe necessarily an apocalyptic event, but just the whole timeline's messed up? I could see that. The show's always been about, messing with the timeline. But I think that some of these changes sound like they're for the better. So I don't know if things necessarily need to be changed. It might be, moving forward in this new timeline. Because, hey, by the way, this new timeline at least gets around the first apocalypse. So everyone's, the Earth survives. So you don't want to mess with that. So maybe not fixing the timeline, but fixing the world they've created. Oh, it sounds excellent. So what are you hoping to see in season three of the Umbrella Academy? Share your thoughts down below, subscribe today, and of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.